Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to my channel, Learn with Deepika. By now, you must be familiar with different type of trigonometric ratios and their values. And in this video, we are going to study exercise 8.2 of NCERT, and that's very easy. So let's start with our question number 1. Evaluate the following. First part, sine 60. Cos 30 plus sine 30 and cos 30. Here we will substitute the values of sine 60, and where sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Value of cos 30 is also root 3 by 2. Plus sine 30 is 1 by 2. Value of cos 60 is also 1 by 2. By using board mass, that means we will multiply this first. Root 3 into root 3 is 3, 2 into 2, 4, plus 1 by 4. 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4 is 4 upon 4, which comes out to be 1. Similarly, we will solve our second part. 2 tan square 45 plus cos square 30 minus sine square 60. Value of tan 45 is 1, and we will square plus cos square 30. Value of cos 30 is root 3 by 2. You will square it. Minus sine 60. And value of sine 60 is also root 3 by 2. Now, 2 multiply by 1. Square of 1 is 1. And then root 3 square is 3. 2 square is 4. Minus 3 upon 4. From there, you'll get 2, and 3 by 4 minus 3 by 4 is 0. So our final answer is 2. Third part is cos 45 degree upon sec 30 degree plus cosec 30 degree. Student, in this question, there is no need to learn all the values of trigonometric ratios, because if you know the value of sine theta, cos theta and tan theta, then by doing reciprocal, you'll get the value of cosec theta, which is reciprocal of sine theta, and sec theta, which is reciprocal of cos theta, and cot theta, which is reciprocal of tan theta. So in this, we know the value of cos 45, that is 1 upon root 2, and sec 30 degree is reciprocal of cos 30 degree. So let's find the value of cos 30. Cos 30 is root 3 upon 2. That means sec 30 is 2 upon root 3. Similarly, cosec 30 degree is reciprocal of sine 30, and value of sine 30 is 1 upon 2. So this will be 2 upon 1. Now you will do the calculation. 1 upon root 2. Take LCM. LCM is root 3. This will be 2 plus 2 root 3. Next step, 1 upon root 2 multiply by root 3 upon 2 plus 2 root 3 by taking reciprocal. And in numerator, you will get root 3. In denominator, this will become 2 root 2 plus 2 root 6 by multiplying root 2 with this bracket. Now, we have to rationalize it by taking conjugate of 2 root 2 plus 2 root 6. This is the conjugate, and that will come in denominator as well. So we will multiply numerator part first. This will become 2 root 6 minus 2 root 6 into 3 is 18 upon. If you see, this is a formula for a plus b and a minus b. There is an identity. And so you can write here a square minus b square, where a is the first term and b is the second term. 2 root 2 whole square minus 2 root 6 whole square. So let's solve it. You will get 2√6 − 2√18 in numerator and in denominator. Square of 2√2 is 8, and this is 24. Now from numerator, 2√6 − 2√18. I'll write 18 as 3 × 3, 9 × 2, 18. So that you can take 3 common from this square root. And in denominator, you will get −16. 2√6 minus, when you take 3 common, you will get 3 × 2, 6√2 upon −16. Then, if you take 2 common from numerator, √6 − 3√2 upon −16. This will be 8. So finally, your answer will be 3√2 − √6/8. There was minus sign in denominator, so I multiplied the numerator and denominator by minus sign. So that's why I'm getting 3√2 − √6/8. So this is your final answer. In this part also, we have substituted values of this trigonometric ratios, and after that there is only calculation part. Let's write fourth part, sin 30° + tan 45 − cosec 60 / sec 30 + cos 60 + cot 45. So let's write all the values. Sin 30, 1/2, tan 45 is 1, and cosec 60 is 2/√3. Sec 30 is also 2/√3. Cos 60 is 1/2, and cot 45 is 1. Now we will take LCM in numerator and in denominator both. So let's take the LCM. This will be 2√3. So numerator √3, and here 2√3. Sorry, it's minus sign. And 4. And in denominator, this comes out to be 2√3. This will become 4 + √3 + 2√3. We'll do simplification. 2√3 + √3 is 3√3 minus 4/√3. And by taking reciprocal of this, 2√3 will be numerator, and √3 + 2√3 is 3√3 + 4. We can cancel out 2√3. In numerator, 3√3 − 4, and in denominator it is 3√3 + 4. We will do rationalization by multiplying the conjugate of 3√3 + 4 and 3√3 − 4. In numerator, you can see there is an identity, which is a minus b whole square. A minus b whole square is a square minus 2ab plus b square. And in denominator, there is the identity a plus b multiplied by a minus b, which is a square minus b square. So by using these two identities, this in denominator and this identity in numerator, we can write it this way: 3√3 − 4 whole square, and in denominator 3√3 whole square − 4 square. So a square 3√3 square − 2ab, 2 multiplied by 3√3 multiplied by 4 plus 4 square. In denominator, this will be 3 root 3 square is 3 square 9 into 3, 27, and here it is 16. So 27 minus 24 root 3 plus 16 upon 11. And 27 plus 16 is 43 minus 24 root 3 upon 11. So that's our final answer. Similarly, you can solve fifth part of this question, and still if you are not able to solve that question, you can post your doubt in comment section. So let's start our question number 2. Question number 2. Choose the correct option and justify your choices. 2 tan 30 degree upon 1 plus tan square 30, and these are the options. So let's solve this. 2 tan 30, value of tan 30 is 1 upon root 3. 1 plus tan square 30. So 1 plus 1 upon root 3 whole square. In numerator, you will get 2 upon root 3. And in denominator, 1 plus square of 1 upon root 3 is 1 upon 3. So 2 upon root 3 by taking LCM is 3 and 3 plus 1. From there, you will get 2 upon root 3 upon 4 upon 3. By taking reciprocal, 3 upon 4, we can cancel out this. So 3 upon 2 root 3. If you cancel out this, like 3 is actually root 3 multiplied by root 3. So you can cancel out this, root 3 upon 2. So now an option, sine 60, value of sine 60 is root 3 upon 2. So that will be our answer. Whereas the value of cos 60 is 1 upon 2, tan 60 is root 3, and sine 30 is 1 upon 2. So this is our final answer, sine 60 degree. Similarly, we will solve our second part. 1 minus tan square 45. Value of tan 45 is 1. So it's 1 minus 1 square upon 1 plus 1 square, which will be 1 minus 1, 1 plus 1. So it's 0 upon 2, 0. So out of this, 0 is the option D. Third part, sine 2a is equals to 2 sine a is true when a is equals to. So you have to find the value of a, like sine 2a is equals to 2 sine a. We have 4 options in this. So I'll substitute value of a one by one with these options. Like first option, value of a is 0. 2 sine 0. Let's see whether LHS side is equals to RHS side in this or not. So this will become sine 0 and here 2 sine 0. Student, value of sine 0 degree is 0. You can see LHS side is equals to RHS side. So this case is true for the first option. So value of A is equals to 0 degree. Likewise, we will solve this part, 2 tan 30 upon 1 minus tan square 30 degree. Value of tan 30 is 1 upon root 3 and 1 minus 1 upon root 3 whole square. So in numerator, you will get 2 upon root 3 and in denominator, 1 minus square of 1 upon root 3 is 1 upon 3. Now we will take LCM, 2 upon root 3. By taking LCM, it's 3 minus 1. Now you will get the value 2 upon root 3 upon 2 upon 3. by taking reciprocal 3 upon 2. We can cancel out this and root 3 by 3, you will get root 3. Now in option, you have to find the values and have to check which of the following are having same value as this expression is having. Root 3. Now we'll find their values as well. Cos 60 is 1 upon 2. Sin 60 is root 3 upon 2. Tan 60 is root 3. So this will be our final answer. Option C. So let's solve question number 3. If tan A plus B is equals to root 3 and tan A minus B is equals to 1 upon root 3, where A plus B lies in the range of 0 to 90 degree and A is greater than B, find A and B. Tan A plus B is equals to root 3. This is given to us. And root 3 is value of tan 60 degree. So I'll write tan A plus B is equals to tan 60 degree. From here I can write that value of A plus B is equals to 60 degree. And that's our equation number 1. And this is also given that tan A minus B is equals to 1 upon root 3, whereas 1 upon root 3 is equals to tan 30 degree. So I'm going to write tan A minus B is equals to tan 30 degree. From there you can write A minus B is equals to 30 degree. And that's our equation number 2. Here you can see two simultaneous equations, and we can solve them by using elimination method. Like from equation 1, A plus B is equals to 60 degree, and another equation A minus B is equals to 30 degree. Using elimination method, A plus B minus B cancel out, and this will be 2A is equals to 90 degree. If 2A is equals to 90 degree, then value of A is equals to 45 degree. By substituting this value in equation first, A plus B is equals to 60 degree, and I'm substituting this value 45 degree plus B is equals to 60 degree. Value of B is equals to 60 minus 45. So it's 15 degree. That means in this question, value of A is equals to 45 degree and value of B is equals to 15 degree. In this case, we have A greater than B, which is our first condition, and sum of A plus B. Sum of A plus B is 60 degree, which is in this range. So that's our final answer. So students, here you have the last question of this exercise, in which you have to answer whether the statements are true or false. First part, sin A plus B is equals to sin A plus sin B. Let's take value of A is equals to 30 degree and value of B is equals to 60 degree. So in this case, sin A plus B, 60 plus 30 is 90, whereas sin A is sin 30 and sin B is sin 60. Let's check whether the LHS side is equals to RHS. Sin 90 is equals to 1, sin 30 is 1 upon 2 and sin 60 is root 3 upon 2. That means our LHS side is not equals to RHS side. So this statement is false. Next part, the value of sin theta increases as theta increases. Let's take the values of theta 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. Value of sine 0 is 0, sine 30 is 1 upon 2, sine 45 is 1 upon root 2, this is root 3 upon 2 and last value is 1. Now we will check whether the values are increasing or decreasing. Let's make the denominators same. If I write 0 as 0 upon 2, then it's fine. And also I'll rationalize it and we can write it as root 2 upon 2. This is already, denominator is already 2 in this case, and here I'm going to write 2 upon 2. Denominators are same and numerators are 0, 1, root 2, root 3 and 2. So it is clear that numerator are increasing whereas the denominators are same. That means value of sine theta is increasing for value of theta. So that statement is true. Next one, the value of cos theta increases as the value of theta increases. Okay, let's check. Value of cos 0 is 1. Value of cos 30 is root 3 upon 2. And cos 45 is 1 upon root 2. 30 is 1 upon 2. And the last value, cos 90 is 0. We have already checked the order of these numbers. So you can see it is decreasing. When we are increasing the value of theta, value of cos theta is decreasing. So this statement is false. Next is, sine theta is equals to cos theta for all the values of theta. No, this statement is false. Only for 45 degree. When theta is 45 degree, that time sine 45 is equals to cos 45 is equals to 1 upon root 2. Otherwise, it's not possible. Like sine 0 cannot be equals to cos 0 or for any other values as well. Cot A is not defined for A is equals to 0. Value of cot 0 is not defined. So this statement is true. So that was our last question. So thank you. See you in my next video. Bye and take care.